Welcome to our ATV Predict tutorial. In this video, we'll guide you through the key steps to optimize your pumping application using ATV Predict. This video is not a substitute for all pertinent documentation. Before performing work with the content described in this video, you must read and understand the contents of all pertinent documentation. Installation, commissioning, maintenance, and disposal must be performed by qualified personnel only. First, purchase your ATV Predict license based on the VSD power rating and the components you want to address, the VSD, motor, and pump. Next, install the license using SoMove. Follow these steps in the installation wizard. First, connect to the drive using the built-in web server feature. Navigate through the interface until you reach the Predictive Maintenance section. If you find that the license isn't valid, open SoMove and click the License Management button. The application will show available drives. Choose the drive you need. And connect. SoMove will then display the License Management window for the connected drive. Click the Add License button and enter the activation ID. After adding the license to our system, we can see its type, product name, and description clearly displayed in our interface. Click Install. If the license is added correctly, the status will be green. Now, going back to the web server, we can access the predictive maintenance. Step 3. Use the web server commissioning wizard for ATV Predict setup. On the predictive commissioning webpage, choose ATV Predict activation. The status is updated to commissioning in progress. Click Next Step. On the next page, you'll find details about the drive. You can adjust the VSD rated maintaining useful life here. Let's set it to 15 years. Set the motor parameters on the next page. Our motor has 5.5 kilowatts rated power. Nominal voltage 400 volts. Nominal frequency 50 hertz. The nominal motor speed is 2,900 revolutions per minute. If needed, we can adjust the motor's rated remaining useful life. Let's set it to 12 years. Here we can apply auto-tuning of the motor. When the auto-tuning is complete, the status will change from yellow to green. Next step, select the right application. We select the pump and view the system, showing inlet pressure, the pump, outlet pressure, and flow meter. The status is displayed above each device. We select inlet pressure. Our pressure sensor is connected to AI1 with a voltage signal. Use millibar for units. Now, we need to scale the sensor to align the physical and process values. We adjust the corrective offset and gain if needed. We can see the status is changed to green. Next step, click on flow sensor. Our flow is connected to AI3. It has voltage type of the analog signal. We change the units to the liters per minute according to our application. Now we can scale the signal so that the physical value will correspond to the process value. Now we can configure the pump. Depending on the available information, we can select which curve data is managed and will be entered. We select net positive suction head, pressure, and flow data to be activated. Pump wheel stages number is 1. Pump speed for which curves are entered is 2,900 revolutions per minute. We can adjust the application's asset rated remaining useful time. For example, let's set it to 8 years. Next, we need to enter the pump curve point by point. In this video, we don't show these actions and proceed to the validation. When clicking on pump curve's validation, we can see that the status indicator turns green. Now we can see that status of all parts of our status is green. We can click Next Step. And now we can exit the wizard. Now we can see the Predictive Maintenance Application Diagnostics dashboard with information about the variable speed drive and the pump. Running ATV Predict, we can monitor various KPIs for performance analysis. Device is ready. Let's start the application. During acceleration, the dashboard updates in real time based on current conditions. This phase is more demanding than stable application, so messages may appear and then disappear until we reach steady state. We will gradually start to close the inlet valve, allowing us to observe the development of cavitation within the system. As we proceed, the dashboard begins to display a noticeable rise in stress levels, accompanied by a series of new and intriguing messages related to prediction and recommendation. These updates provide valuable insights as we analyze the situation further. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.